Hello, this is Javita, and welcome to another episode of 7 Days to Die. Leave last episode, I ended in the police station. Kind of spent the night there and, you know, looted it. Just turned morning. Anyway, didn't find anything too earth-shattering, and then I basically just decided to go ahead and take a couple of days. We're on day 12 now. And just kind of grind out some stuff. This up at the top is kind of what I found in the police station. Found these awesome purple pistol parts. Also found a complete pistol. I then went and spent a day basically breaking open the bank. This is kind of the cream of the crop. Apparently, I guess they added gold. Yeah, sounds like they might be for trading, maybe. Yeah, when mining, you'll occasionally find rare metals and ores. Surely they are worth something to someone. So, but anyway, so found some bunch of schematics for iron armor, found SMG schematic, a sawed off shotgun, nail gun, which is essentially the best construction tool, enforcer magazine, which is actually for the 44 Magnum. So, be able to put those together now. Then we also got an airdrop. This is the same thing as last time. It was marked on my map, and this time I actually made a waypoint where the marker was. And then, you know, when I actually got around to looting it, the marker wasn't visible, but I had still marked it. So, but that was this stuff right here is what was in the airdrop. I got another quest. Got sniper rifle stock, rocket launcher parts, and then this is just kind of some random stuff that I found. So, finally found a new wrench, and I actually have all the stuff to make a workbench, finally. I'm just going to dump all this into the gun area. Managed to find a claw hammer. With the new wrench, I was able to get the last bit of mechanical parts I needed. Then everything else is pretty... I wanted to use this broken wrench, so just in case, I'm going to throw the good one down and craft. So I'll take about 3 minutes. Get my good wrench. We can make crossbow as well. So I know we need leather. Okay, it's duct tape. I knew there was something else I was forgetting. And crossbow. Finally. Okay, well, while this stuff is crafting, I'm going to go off camera and basically wait until then. Okay, we're back. There we go. Woo! Look at that. I was digging this trench while the workbench was crafting when I heard some dogs being damaged by my spikes. About made me have a heart attack. Looks like they're just passing through. Apparently this is a dog day, if that's even still a thing. I think in this new update they've made it to where the difficulty more scales to how well you're doing. So if you're on day 7 and you know you've never died and you're doing great, you'll encounter more zombies and harder zombies than say if you had died 3 times. And I think it goes off of level as well. Have to be kind of careful today, I guess. Luckily, they had to have been over here on these spikes. Of course, I was over here digging this. But anyway, let's see here. Yeah, the workbench and the crossbow are finished. So let's go slap the workbench down. I think that works. Okay, so it's very much like the chemistry station, except pretty sure it can craft just about anything here and then just leave it unattended. So we could craft up to make, let's see here, a bunch of log spikes, let's say 100, and then just leave it there, and it's not taking up our inventory. So, nice. Of course, dumps it there. Another thing that's really cool is you can combine like items here. It's a good example. Let's see here, bow. Let's make, let's say, 10 of these. They're nice and cheap, so that in. About 10 of these. What we'll be able to do is bring them over here. So we got item A, item B, and then here's the result. So you can take two items, combine them together, and the quality will increase. If one of them is significantly lower, or if one is particularly damaged, there's kind of like a value that will go towards either improving the item, or if there's durability to be repaired, then it will be spent to repair it, and then anything left over will be used to improve. So repairs and then improves. But what this means is if you're willing to spend the resources on making things over and over, you can potentially get better tools and weapons before you can actually outright craft them. See, now we're getting into purple. Yeah, it looks like I need more bows if I want to continue that. But particularly on these cheap tools, it's kind of like, why not? It's nice. Got purple bow, purple axe. Let's see here. Let's, well, might as well make, there we go, perfect 600 axe. Grins and giggles. Yeah, so once you get the max, you can't do anything else with it. Okay, perfect 600 bow. Let's go ahead and combine the extras. Ooh. Is that what I think it is? That might be a screamer. Yep. Cool. Yes. Say hello. She didn't do her scream. Looks like, that's only two. Yeah, usually when they first see you, they'll scream and call in essentially a little mini horde. Which looks like more or less did that, she just didn't do her scream. Nice. Yeah, man. But yeah, when you get really advanced in the game, the screamers can call in essentially, you know, a horde that rivals the real deal. Nice. Ooh, more glue. Yeah. Now I find it, now that I don't really need it. Okay, so. First screamer. Nothing too exciting, but. Certainly, didn't call any dogs or anything like that. So, I don't think I ever really finished explaining what I did with my 2 days that I took off camera, but one of the things I did is came over here and started a garden. So this would be cotton right here, goldenrod, this right here is corn, and then, I don't remember if that's yucca or aloe vera. I think it's yucca. But, and then this was just kind of, I don't know, the only time I ever want a garden hoe is when I'm out here in the garden, so I just plop a box down, but just kind of show you how this works in case you're somehow unfamiliar. Is you basically just come along and just right click. Let's see here. Yeah, you can hold it down. And if you have fertilizer, you can upgrade the soil even further. I believe how the new crop system works is that you can plant basically anything on just the regular dirt. However, it will only basically reproduce itself. So if you have one seed, you're going to get one product out of it if you plant it in dirt. If you plant it in tilled soil, you'll get more. And I think that largely depends on the actual crop that you're growing. If you have fertilizer, you can upgrade the soil even further and you get a higher yield. So if you have, say, you know, aloe vera or something that you just, or just anything that's high priority, you can put fertilizer on. However, fertilizer is a very kind of costly and timely thing to try to make. Yeah, both it's costly in both materials and time is what I'm trying to say. Another thing I did was, you know, I was really trying to find more iron, so I worked a fair amount on the tunnel slash mine to basically no avail. I mean, it's bigger, but really didn't get, you know, I was hoping to find minerals and didn't find anything, so I kind of gave up on that for that time being and went around and broke a lot of rocks. So, got a decent amount of iron smelting into the forges as we speak. I think my general plan is to go ahead and do the next 7-day horde here. Kind of spruce up the place, reinforce the defenses. That's why I'm digging this trench, just so I can put down another row of spikes. And maybe after the next horde, kind of pack it up and go visit the trader, which is somewhere to the south. Let's go to quest. And toggle active. So yeah, trader's way down here somewhere. There we go. And since that is such a far journey, and we've kind of seen what there is to see in this town, we might just kind of go nomadic a little bit and find another town to live in, because we at least need another town to loot. But anyway, I'm going to finish this trench off camera and we'll be back. Okay, so I went ahead and threw the spikes in there once I dug it out. Really? Managed to use up all my wood. Okay. So, that's something I can do off camera or even do at night. Let's look into, let's see here. Yeah, barbed wire fence. What am I missing here? Tool? No. Okay. Hello. Nice. Anybody else? Guess not. Oh, there's somebody. Here, boy. Here, boy. Come on. Yeah. Haha. They seem easier to kill than I remember. Okay. So, well, it's already 6 o'clock. So, let's go ahead. Just kind of work on upgrading some of these spikes. Yeah, something I'm thinking of doing, since I didn't really get just a whole lot accomplished this episode, is to go ahead and maybe play another day and kind of merge it into one episode. So I have a little bit of kind of home stuff and then some more interesting footage to look at. Okay, so we got some pretty major improvements underway for the fort. Preparation for the day 14 horde. We're starting to craft iron bars, which that will replace this skirt. It'll be significantly more durable. What's that damaged? Apparently so. There we go. Apparently I guess this needs to kind of back up a little bit more so they can't beat on that. But anyway, we can use the iron bars to upgrade this skirt. It'll kind of remove this kind of bumpy stuff that we're having to walk on. Also later on, they're fat cops basically, and they can actually spit or vomit at you. kind of some acidy stuff and tear up your skirt, building, and you if you get hit by it. So yeah, this wood skirt really doesn't work for when you get those, but hopefully it'll be like maybe day 21 or, you know, the day 21 horde before we get any of those. But we got all the spikes upgraded to essentially tier 2 or level 2. We still have some metal spikes. I don't know if we're going to try to upgrade the metal spikes, but we are. But what I am working on is getting more barbed wire crafted. Basically what this will do is they can still walk through it, but it will slow them down. So it'd be kind of nice to get kind of a perimeter that will slow the zombies down and make them easier targets before they come and start tearing up these spikes. So, we'll see. So I'd like to get a ring of that around the house potentially, see how well it works. Used to and use, here we go, wood spikes. But yeah, look at that, 100. So that's a pretty steep price considering how long it takes us to gather wood. Not sure why this is here. I mean, I guess once we have a chainsaw, it won't be so bad, but oh, here we go. Yeah. Oh, gotta load the bow. Actually, I wanted to look. Let's see here. Bow. So it does, wow, 45 entity damage. That's a pretty, well, I think maybe it was doing 37 before. Crossbow's still better, but not by just a whole lot. Oh, he just flat out died on the spikes. Stop messing my spikes up, dudes. Yeah, let's go hunting. Come on. Yeah. Jeez, one bite, infected and bleeding. Good thing I have plenty of bandages. Come on. Nobody else? Oh, free leather. Well, not really free. It's costing me bandages and, there we go. Bandages and I guess honey? Should have plenty of honey. Cure that infection. Anyway, well, this was, Javita. Thanks for watching. Pretty sure, we'll just have to wait and see. Might merge this episode, or merge this day with another day to, you know, because did a lot of just kind of home improvement type stuff, so we'll see. Hello. Thought I was done. Sounds like, yeah, got a screamer over there, some more dogs. I guess that's a dead dog, I'm not sure. Yeah, there we go. Damn. Oh, we got spider zombies. Damn. Good thing I didn't put the barbed wire down. I was halfway thinking about getting down there with them, but geez, that sounds pretty bad. Okay. There's like, what? One of them left that can actually run? Well, two. So. Well, looks like I'm gonna get cold here. Come on. Is he caught on his buddies or something? Yeah, on the ground. Ooh, missed. Fail. There's one. Nice. So yeah, screamers. Lots of fun. Let's see, we're pretty darn cold. There was something else I was wearing that maybe was cooling me down, but it's funny. The weather's turning out to be more dangerous than the zombies. Here we go. Let's put that on. Yeah. Eek! Ankle biter? Anybody else? All these spikes, they messed up. Oh, I forgot to loot them. Well, looks like that was most of the excitement, so this time for real. It's Javita, thanks for watching. Till next time.